Of course, I'm deeply honored to co-host this event, celebrating an individual who has had so much impact on the lives of many, certainly including myself. What a noble example he has given to the whole world. His life and his deeds tells us, do not be faint of heart. Do not be faint of heart. Against any adversity, do not give up. Do not lose hope.
Liberation he did bring to India. At the same time, he gave the thought of reasoning to liberate from one's own restrictive thoughts to that of meaningful deeds. His natural instincts of equality of humankind, regardless of caste, creed or status, was phenomenal. Mahatma Gandhi is revered the world over as one of history's most transformative and inspirational figures.
Every single one of us has taken a part in us not just to look after us and our families, but we've gone out there and looked after other fellow members of a community, and that itself is one message of a Mahatma in you. And a Mahatma in me concept was actually generated by Nilesh Makwana and Lenny Makwana, the artist. They actually started the Borderless Gandhi with a Mahatma in me as their first campaign at Elizabeth Keys back in 2015. And I can say that again, that the resilience and the ability for them to execute that project was tremendously challenging, but it was fruitful. And look at where they are now. They continue to spread that message. And I thank them for their efforts in bringing this beautiful concept and generosity and welcoming other members of the community to share the Mahatma in them.
On behalf of Indian Society of Western Australia, I'd like to extend my thanks and gratitude to all of you for being here and gracing this occasion, this Gandhi Jayanti celebration, which is an extremely significant event. It is significant not only for the Indian diaspora, but as all of our special guests and speakers have already mentioned, it actually goes beyond borders, it goes beyond nations, it goes beyond time and beyond generation.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests and community members, I'm really pleased to have been asked to extend a vote of thanks. Tonight's event brings to mind the weaving of a khadi, the meticulous joining by hand of many fine threads to create a beautiful product.
Mr. Yaz, you said about Mahatma in me, and I thought the young generation, which are the future leader of tomorrow, what do they see about Gandhi? How do they, what message do they convey to themselves and to us?
This message, truth alone prevails. No matter what you do, no matter wherever we go, truth will stand out there. That's the most important thing.
So Gandhi wanted to attain economic equality and through non-violent method. When it comes to economic equality, it stays as a question mark that whether we have attained economic equality or not.
So the idea I'm going to talk about is the simplicity. So everyone who knows about Gandhi, he is meant for simplicity. So that we can identify from his dresses and the ideas which he spoke.
One of my favorite quotes about Gandhi, which inspires Steve Jobs the most, be the change you wish the world to see.
And once again, it's not easy to come together and celebrate and collaborate. It's been a lot of WhatsApping going on, email going on, phone call going on, meeting going on between the different groups. But I'm glad that it all went really well. And I think Gandhi was with us today to make sure that it all goes in a peaceful manner and everything comes together. So would you say that we did celebrate together today?
Yes.
Yeah. So it's a success, right? Yeah.